Okay, some basic specs. I'll not go over too many hygiene items. It's a 313cc DOHC engine, 4 valves. One interesting part of the engine is that, as you can see, the exhaust is from the rear and the intake is from the front. The entire piston or the cylinder block has been turned 180 degrees, which is something very nice which BMW has done. Because of this, the exhaust pipe itself becomes very short, so performance is enhanced. Additionally, they have been able to fit a really long swing arm. So for a bike of this small engine size, it has got a nicely splayed out wheelbase of 1420 mm. Ground clearance is 220 mm, good for a bike of this type. Excellent suspension, 41 mm forks in front, upside downs, and spring-loaded damper in the rear, 180 mm travel, front and rear both. Wheels, 19 in front, 17 in the rear, as befits a soft adventure bike. A word about the tires. The tire rating for this bike is H, H for Hunter, that is 210 km per hour. Stock tires are Metzeler's. If people want, they can shift to cheaper Timson's also later. The tank capacity is 12 liters, usable is 11 liters, a bit more about that later. Lights, an H4 halogen 6555 and incandescent 5 watt bulbs all around. There are two LEDs, one LED for the main brake light and one LED for the license plate. Okay, instrument panel. Now, let's show them the instrument panel and the various mode. This is a very simple LCD instrument panel. As you can see, there are the warning lights here for the high beam, the turn indicator, the fuel gauge warning, fuel warning, and the neutral. This is the vertical ramp for the fuel gauge. Onto its right is the particular mode setting, which now is an odo. This is the odometer. Like I said, it's almost a 10,000 km review. Below that is the speed indicator, that is the speedometer. Underneath is the horizontal ramp for the RPM. As you can see, the red band is indicated from 10,000 to 12,000 RPM. Above that is the gear. Here it says first gear, so the bike doesn't move forward. And this is the clock. Now, here I want to show you that the ABS light is flickering. This means that the vehicle's ABS has not yet calibrated. Once the vehicle is in motion, it gets calibrated at 5 km per hour and this light will go out. Here, there are some engine warning indicators. Plus, this is another warning indicator. So, this rounds out the instrument panel. Various modes. So, here I am showing you odometer. Here is the trip 1. This is the trip 2. This is the engine temperature. This is the range available for this particular fuel in the tank. This is the consumption, which presently is 3.4 liters for 100 kilometers. A bit more about that later. This is the average fuel consumption, which now is obviously zero because the bike is not in motion. This is the speed, the last registered speed. This is the date, and this is for setting up of the date and various things, and back to the odometer. Left hand controls. Come, we'll show them left hand controls. Standard motorcycle controls. You've got a flasher, the high beam and low beam indicator. When the bike is switched on, the low beam acts as a daytime running light. Turn indicator, this is the horn, mirrors, clutch lever, and left handlebar. What about the ABS? This is a switchable ABS. You can switch it on and off in motion. So when you switch it on in motion, we'll show them there. Here the ABS indicator is blinking because it is switched on, yet to be calibrated. Now we'll switch off the ABS and the light will stay on continuously. Please note, when the light is on continuously, it means that the ABS is not working, or rather it has been disabled. When I switch on the ABS, that light will start flashing once again. Right hand controls. Standard, you have got the engine kill switch, handlebar, the front brake, and the front master cylinder for the hydraulic fluid, the mirrors, and the ignition switch. The ignition will not turn on, it will not even spool up if the bike is in gear like it is now and the side stand is down. This is a good active safety feature. Fuel tank is an excellent aluminium aircraft type fuel tank, and inside there is a small ramp. A small bar, you know, a small metal bar. Can we see that? Yes, here where the pointer is indicating. So this acts as an active fuel spillage measure. So when the fuel starts reaching this, it touches this, the pump switches off on its own. So if there is any careless fuel attendant, the bike will not spill over. Quickly, sharply put in and back. Seat width, you can see an excellent broad seat. Here it's about 9 inches, here it's about 12 inches, and the pillion widest is about 10.5 inches. So you have got 12 inches of broad space, so your rear is well supported on long rides or when you are trying to do off-road and you land out here, you'll not slip off. Tail rack, BMW has given an excellent tail rack here to fit various top cases. It's very solid aluminium. I've removed it, it's quite heavy also. Looks very smart, affords some kind of a protection from the rear. So in the next section, we'll speak about likes, dislikes.